From time immemorial, man has been on the quest to know the meaning and purpose of life. Through the years, man has attempted to unveil the mystery called life. Why do I suffer? Why am I here? Where do I come from? Where am I going to from here? And above all, who am I? These questions ring prominent in the minds of men. After many years of penance, some have succeeded, and they are known as sages and saints. These sages have, out of the compassion for mankind, proclaimed to the world, "Oh man, you are not just this body of mere flesh and bones. You are immortal Atman. You are radiant divinity. Realize this and be free." This production is a witness to such a one. His name is Swami Sivananda.
Practical way to self-realization. Beloved immortal self, thou art divine. Live at peace. Feel and realize thy divine nature. Thou art the master of your destiny. Do not be discouraged when sorrows, difficulties and tribulations manifest in the daily battle of life. Draw courage and spiritual strength from within. There is a vast inexhaustible magazine of power and knowledge within you. Learn the ways to tap the source. Dive deep within. Sink down. Plunge in the sacred waters of immortality. Behold it remaining within. You will be quite refreshed, renovated and unified when you go to the divine source and realize, I am the immortal self or Atman. Do not grumble when troubles and sorrows descend upon you. Every difficulty is an opportunity for you to develop your will and to grow strong. Welcome it. Difficulties strengthen your will, augment your power of endurance, and turn your mind towards God. Face them with a smile. In your weakness lies your real strength. You are invincible. Nothing can harm you. Conquer the difficulties one by one. This is the beginning of a new life, a life of expansion, glory, and divine splendor. Aspire and draw. Grow, expand. Build up all positive, virtuous qualities, the daily sampati, namely fortitude, patience, and courage that are dormant in you. Start a new life. Tread the spiritual path and realize I am the immortal self or Atman. Have a new angle vision. Arm yourself with discrimination, cheerfulness, discernment, alacrity, and understanding spirit. Claim thy birthright now, thou art immortal self or Atman. Determination and self-reliance are very necessary for success in self-realization. In Mundaka Upanishads you will find, this Atman cannot be attained by one who is destitute of strength or without earnestness or by penance without mark. But if a wise man strives after it by those means, then he is self-interested to Brahman. Fearlessness is an important qualification for an aspirant. Such thing as sin. Sin is only a mistake. Sin is a mental creation. The baby soul must commit some mistake during the process of evolution. Mistakes are your best teachers. The idea of sin will be blown in the air if you think, I am the immortal self or Atman. Don't say karma, karma. My karma has brought me like this. Exact, exact. Do purushartha, do tapas. Concentrate, purify, meditate. Don't become a fatalist. Don't yield to inertia. Don't bleat like a lamb. Roar, 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 roar like a lion of Vedanta. See how Markandeya, who was destined to die at his 16th year, became a Chiranjeevi, an immortal boy of 16 years, on account of his tapas. Also note how Savitri, by her tapas, brought back to her life her dead husband. How Benjamin Franklin and the late Party Muthuswami Iyer of Madras Bench indicated themselves. The man was my dear Naranjan, that man is master of his destiny. Vishwamitra Rishi, who was a Kshatriya Raja, became a Brahma Rishi. like Vasishtha, and even created a third world for Pasenku by his power of tapas. Rogratanagar became the sage, while Miki through tapas, Rose, Jedi and Madai of Bengal became highly developed saints. They became the disciples of Gauranga. What others have done, he can also do. There is no doubt of this. He can also do wonders and miracles if you apply yourself to spiritual sadhana, tapas and meditation. Read the book Poverty to Power by James Allen. With interest and attention, you'll be inspired. Draw the program of your life. Follow the 20 important spiritual instructions and 40 golden precepts. Read my book, Sure Ways for Successful Life and God Realization. Adhere to the spiritual routine. Apply yourself with zeal and enthusiasm to sadhana. Become a naistic brahmachari. Be steady and systematic in your spiritual practices. Shine in your own day, pristine, very glory. Become a jivan mukta, ramanda, thou art the children of immortality. Hey, Sonya, dear immortal self, be bold, be cheerful, though you are down and out, though you have nothing to eat, though you are clad in rags, the essential nature is such balance, existence absolute, knowledge absolute and bliss absolute. His outer cloak, his mortal physical shape, his illusory maya production, smile, whistle, laugh, jump, dance in joy and ecstasy. See Om Om Om, Ram Ram Ram, Sham Sham Sham, Shivoham Shivoham Shivoham. Soham, 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 come out of this change of flesh. The word non-dispensable body. The word immortal self-atman. The word sexless atman. The word is son of king of kings. An emperor of emperors. Brahma who punishes the atman who dwells in the chambers of your heart. Arve guha. Act as such. Feel as such. Claim your birthright now from this very second. Feel as such. Realize. Not from tomorrow or the day after. Right now from this very second. Tattvamasi Dava Dharanjan, Dava Dimbuat of Self or Atman. Brother, courage is thy birthright and not fear. Peace is thy divine heritage, not restlessness. Immortality but not mortality. Strength but not weakness. Health but not disease. Bliss but not sorrow. Knowledge but not ignorance. You are the architect of your own fate and fortune. You are the master of your own destiny. You can do a lot of things. You can attain brahmahood by right thinking, right feeling, right acting. You can break all the bodily habits by the power of will. You can destroy wrong samskaras, unholy desires, wrong imaginations. You can build new habits. You can change your nature. You can build a beautiful character. You can move the whole world by your spiritual force. You can elevate others also to the status of divinity. You can control the force of nature. You can command the elements. Rely on your own self. Do not be credulous. Believe not in any dark voice. You have the inner voice of the soul or promptings of the pure conscience. Be not a slave. Do not sell them with dirty. Do not the immortal self. Destroy the inferiority complex. Draw power, courage, strength from within. Be free. Have no blind faith. Reason out carefully and then accept anything. Do not be carried away by blind, surging emotions. Subdue them. Do not be intolerant. Expand. There is a vast magazine of power and knowledge within you. It deals with vision. When the whole mysteries of the self will be revealed unto thee. The darkness of ignorance will be dispelled by the light and knowledge of the self. Constant meditation on the Atma is the master key to open the realms of knowledge. I have given here the gist of Vedanta in a few lines. Taste the Vedantic nectar and find immortality, eternal bliss and tyranny and joy. It's the goal of life. You will be the end of existence. Karma Yoga and Upasana will prepare you to realize this highest goal. Try to lead a life of non-attachment, discipline your mind gradually. No one is free from pain, diseases, struggles and difficulties. You will have to rest in your own soul, the blissful Atman, the source and support for this life. You will have to remember your own divine nature. There alone you will gain the strength to face the difficulties of life. There alone you will have balanced mind. You will not be affected by external and bothered influences and unpleasant discordant vibration. Regular meditation in the morning will give you new strength and inner life, perennial joy and unalloyed bliss. Practice this. Feel you this despite your adverse stormy conditions. Gradually you will grow spiritually to a current self-realization eventually. Your present ailment is a karmic purgation. It has to come to make you remember him more and more. Please say mercy in your heart to strengthen you and to enable you to develop power and endurance. We pray to God to give her always and blessed you so that she could remember him always. Sattas or joys and suffering more. Disease, pain, scorpions, calamities, etc. are messengers from God. A bhakta welcomes them with a cheerful countenance. He never bumbles. He says once more, I am thine, my Lord. Thou doest everything for my own good. Where there is a room for lamentation and despair, my dear Niranjan, the Lord, dear to the Lord, the reason why he gives troubles, if he wants to take anyone to his side, he takes away all money, he removes his dear kitchen king, he destroys all his precious senses, so that his mind may fully rest at his lotus feet. Face everything with a smiling, cheerful countenance. Understand his mysterious ways, see God in everything. In every face, out of sight but not out of mind, we are closer when we live physically at a distance. Let us dwell in our heart. Krishna suddenly hides himself so that Radha and the gopis might thirst for him more eagerly. Sing like Radha, thirst like gopis for his vision. Krishna's grace is bound to descend. He is the immortal sun. Forget not the fruit bearer of Vrindavan, thy solace and the joy of Devaki. The all-merciful God resides in the chambers of your heart. He is quite close to you, you have forgotten him. But he still cares for you. Troubles are his blessings in disguise. He wants to mold your body and mind as fit instruments for his unhampered play of Leela. He ministers and attends to your wants in a better manner than you yourself will do. Keep the load down that you are carrying on your shoulders unnecessarily on account of your egoism. Give up your self-created responsibilities and be at perfect ease. Have perfect faith in him. Do total unserved self-surrender. Run to him now. He is waiting with outstretched hands to embrace you. He will do everything for you. Believe me, take my word for it. Open your heart to him quite freely like a child. All miseries will come to an end. Say unto him at least once with heart sincerely, I am thine, my Lord. All is thine. Thine will be done. The goal for separation is vanishing now. All miseries, troubles, worries and disease melt away. You will become one with the Lord. Feel that the whole world is your body, your own home. Never can destroy all barriers that separate man from man. Idea of superiority is ignorance of delusion. Isha, Vasivam, Sanam, Devala, Vishwapram, all-embracing, all-inclusive love. United with all, separation is death. Unity is eternal life. The whole world is Vishwabrindavan. Feel that this body is a moving temple of God. Wherever you are, whether at home, office, know you are the temple of God. Younger, work is an offering unto the Lord. Feel that all beings are a vision of God. Transmute every working together are an offering unto the Lord. Have Akarta, Sakshi Bhav, if you are a student of Veda. Have Yoga Bhav, if you are master on the path of Bhakti. Feel that God works through your hands. That one power works through all hands. See through your eyes. Hear through all ears. You will become a changed being. You have new angle of vision. You will enjoy the highest peace and bliss. May the self-abiding Buddha guide you in all your activities, wishing you joy, peace and immortality. Om Shanti, thy own self, Shivananda. Om. understand the laws of the universe, move factually in this world, learn the secrets of nature, try to know the best ways to control the mind, conquer this mind. Conquest of mind is really conquest of nature of the world. Conquest of mind will enable you to go to the source of soul power, and you can then realize I am immortal, self or atman. Future is inviting you. Let the past be buried. You can work miracles. You can do wonders. Do not give up hope. You can destroy the harmful effects of unfavorable planets through your willpower. You can command the elements and the nature. You can utilize the effect of evil influences and the antagonistic dark forces that may operate against you. You can change the unfavorable circumstances into best possible ones. You can nullify destiny. Many have done this. He can also do so. Future is inviting you. Let the past be buried. You can work miracles. You can do wonders. Do not give up hope. You can destroy the harmful effects of unfavorable planets through your willpower. You can command the elements and the nature. You can utilize the effect of evil influences and the antagonistic dark forces that may operate against you. You can change the unfavorable circumstances into best possible ones. You can nullify destiny. Many have done this. He can also do so.